Nothing. Let's see. This is Burble Bottom.
Fest and
happy to finally get to meet you. He's seen a lot of things wash up on his miniature shore, but nothing as exciting as you. Says he loves the surf. He'd be in it all day and night if he could. It must have been upstream only to get to this point in your histo future. But which way are you going now? With the flow or against? It's crazy hard to flipper against the surf, but you can't save the world if you let it sweep you away. Either way, it's a shame the surf has gotten so nasty. Thinks life is like trying to ride a wave. You need to pick the right one, but you don't really know which one that is until you're on top of it. Better to ride a wave than let the perfect one pass you by. What? Seems to him that there's always another wave coming along. Can't imagine how wonderful it's going to be to surf on ghoulous goo. The world is going to live. Can't thank you enough for fighting against the goo. Happy you ride alongside the myriad. They bring a real shine to everything they work with.
Fest and trip.
Thinks that's an excellent point. Riding is life. Work is not nearly as fun.
Fest and trip.
But none of that's nearly as important as enjoying the day, right? He never drank from this pond because of the disgusting things done there. Even the fish stopped drinking here after the pollution made the surf mucked and the air blocked his gills. He figures the Tree of Life isn't drinking either. Or, well, that's not true. He said it does drink, as it has no other choice. It's a tree, but it's forced to drink poison. Claims the surf is poison now. Anything that drinks it becomes poison too, including the Tree of Life. His friend Wiz needs guppos for one reason or another, and Gil is ready to point you in the right direction. But here, you're only going to find dead ones. He's pretty sure Wiz wants them alive. Well, at least the ones that aren't already rotting. If you head in the right direction, you'll find a clean enough bit of surf to snag yourself some guppos. Then you can get them to Wiz for whatever he has in mind. Helping both you and Wiz makes him double happy. That's some good e-waste there. It's okay to smile at the growing light. more than a flesh wound. Well placed. Smashly dash. This is Guppy Grotto. Every day is a new chance to fulfill your destiny. Just a few moves left. Make them count. Don't let the day pass you by. Locked. Just a few moves left. Make them count. Seems like a peculiar item. Hard to find weapons made this good. Definitely not open. Just a few moves left. Make them count. What could see you sneak up on them through this? That seems to be enough guppos to provide the octopod with infinite ammunition. He's surprised the Merkpuff's been able to hold its breath all this time. It's just another proof of the evolutionary change caused by Toxinol's contamination. Being underserf has meant the Merkpuff has been left alone to munch on the root down there undisturbed. This means the northwest root has suffered more damage than the others. The marks the corporation left behind on the land are everywhere, but they also abandoned technology, of which he's sure you only found a fraction. Thank you. That was the last of them. You've sealed the fate of the tribe and the tree. It's time for the end game. You have your destiny. Follow it all the way back to Out of Date. He never told anyone about what's next, but he's sure it involves you. Just continue to stay true to yourself and respect others, whatever happens. You've become their pride, the guiding light of the tribe. It's time to return to the tree one last time. Out of Date says the signs of the end of the world are everywhere. It seems nature is preparing to take revenge. The day of reckoning is coming, and you are invited. He can feel you're approaching the end date. If you haven't decided whom of all like-minded, light-hearted beings you've met have earned a seat on the Ark yet, it's time to do that now. Then grasp your last chance to make sure Lupa Lupin stopped for good. The tree settled its score, but it left yours half done. He says you need to see Lupa Lupin eye to eye one last time. He's happy to help. Says you covered the important things already. Supposedly, mounts like that can smell fear. The Sifu is seeking revenge too. He hasn't forgotten what Lupa Lupin did, but he also wants to stop him from attacking his tribe. That the world seems to survive doesn't mean he must. He hopes you agree, even if it goes against your light-hearted nature. There's no room for predators in the world the Myriad tribe is building. But he knows this is your fight. You should handle it. Lupa Lupin's own fear was his shackles, not the roots of the tree. It just changed him. chance to stand back and let the tribe handle it. Sifu is ready to step into the fray. Are the odds about to change in your favor? If a friend dies, something inside you dies. You can save the Sifu by making yourself a target. You're up. We'll be right back. waves spread when the world crumbles. This is not a prophecy, me telling you about the future. It's you shaping it. Here's a vulgar display of power. The more he does, the stronger he becomes. time you remember who the real enemy is and stop playing the game his way. This is how it ends. The Predator and the world itself suffering. But at least it's a sign they're both still alive.
So, what we have here is a clear matter of life and death, and only you can make a difference.
You continue to make bad decisions and mistakes. Oh, it never ends.
It's easy to make a good decision when there's only one option. The only mistake here is you.
My mistake is letting you speak. My conviction is that the world would be a better place without your voice.
Convincing yourself doesn't win the argument. In the end, we won't remember the words of our enemies, but the silences of our friends.
The weak can't forgive. Forgiveness is a strength. It's not all life and death. It's no better time than now to accept a helping hand. Do you wonder what turn life might have taken if you'd done things different? A left when you went right? A yes when you said no? You've walked the thin line between survival and disaster and haven't lost your balance yet. It's because of you the Tree of Life and the world has been given a second chance. You carried the light in a world full of dark and made a difference in a place that needed change. You allied with the Myriad tribe and acted on understanding of the greater good and a code of honor. However, light and dark does simply represent the polarities of life. One can't exist without the other. This isn't the end. Just being surrounded by nature as it heals itself will rejuvenate us. Nature will teach us how to survive. So, trust your conscience to show you the way, and everything else will follow. But you're not alone. Those that shared your perspective and gained your trust will accompany you on your journey. Is there a world out there that's better suited for those imbalanced in their light nature than this one? Whether or not, we'll leave your story on record, so those who come after will know you followed your light nature and saved the world. So, when all is said and done, it turned out to be an unusual ending after all. What could be better than ending the story the right way? Ending it your way. A beginning of something new.